I just wanted to start by asking about the Raqqa battle. How do you see it so far? Is it better or is it worse than that, than what you have planned?
Well, first, Anand, it's very nice to see you. I think you were just in Raqqa, so you can speak with it firsthand. And I'm here with our military commanders and also some of our diplomats to get a sense of the military situation, also the civilian situation on the ground, the humanitarian situation. So we'll be meeting with some of our military commanders later today. I think the assessment is that this is pretty much on plan. It's going according to the plan that we had laid out. This is going to take a long time. It's a tough battle. I think we have to remember that Raqqa is the capital of this phony caliphate that ISIS declared, and so it'll take a long time. You know, Mosul really, from start to finish, Mosul really started when the Iraqi forces captured Qiyara Air Base about a year ago. So that has actually been a year-long campaign. I don't think Raqqa will take that long, but it'll take time, and we're not going to put a timeline on it. It's tough fighting. It's street by street. There are IEDs and landmines, as you know, and obstacles, as you've seen, and we're facing a suicidal enemy. So it'll take time, but we have no doubt the force that we're working with, the Syrian Democratic Forces, mix of Kurds, an increasing number, I think you were there, saw with your own eyes, Arab coalition forces, Arab forces, particularly local to the area, continue to advance. And we have great confidence in their abilities and that they will succeed.
I have a question about Turkey. Turkey is massing along the border, the northern side. Some of the Kurds that we're talking to, they're saying, like, if the Turks attack us, we're going to have to leave Raqqa and go back to defend our areas. Is the Turkish presence along the border hindering your Raqqa operation? And what kind of message do you have for the Turks?
So, no, right now everything in the Raqqa campaign, again, is according to the plan that we laid out. Again, it's very difficult. It's going to take time, but laying out according to plan. And we continue to consult with the Turks weekly in terms of exactly what's happening and keeping them up to date, because obviously they have a great interest in what happens, particularly in the post-Raqqa phase. And one reason it's great to be here to talk to the Raqqa Civilian Council is about what happens after ISIS in Raqqa, and to make sure that local people from Raqqa are in charge of their own affairs and set the conditions for people to return to their homes. That's really fundamental in the post-ISIS phase. So we're not there yet. We won't be there for some time, but we're in close consultations with Turkey on that. And obviously, in terms of Turkey's own military operations, something we talked to them about quite a bit, and we'll continue to consult with them. But obviously, we would not want anything to happen that would disrupt the Raqqa campaign, because the Raqqa campaign is critical and essential to protecting all of us. That is where so many attacks have been planned around the world, including attacks in Turkey. So that's why Raqqa is so important, and you know, so far we feel pretty good about it, but it'll take some time.
Do you think there are still high-value targets inside the city?
We think there's a significant number of foreign fighters inside the city, and we're continuing to find and pick up some high-value people, particularly even in Topka, which was liberated recently. So, you know, it's hard to say. I think a lot of the leadership has probably fled Raqqa, but in terms of hardcore foreign fighters ready to defend the city and fight to the death, we know that they are concentrated in the city of Raqqa, and our mission is to make sure they cannot escape. The mission is to make sure that no foreign fighters, any foreign fighter who is here, who joined ISIS from a foreign country and came into Syria, they will die here in Syria. That's the mission. So if they're in Raqqa, they're going to die in Raqqa. For Syrians who might have been swept up with ISIS and want to surrender, the Raqqa Civilian Council here last week pardoned about 80 Syrians who had fought with ISIS. So obviously this is something Syrians can work out. But those foreign fighters, those hardcore foreign fighters, we're going to work to make sure that we eliminate.